Good day, everybody! It is AirPirateCid, and I've learned how to control my hyperness to an... well, to a certain degree. Well, anyways, welcome back to more or less play Golden Sun. In the last chapter, all I ended up really doing was just going through a lot of dialogue-heavy story, and also we got the cloak ball right here. You know, the one that Bobby was using to be all, like, invisible ninja-ish or something like that. But anyways, I'm going to demonstrate to you the effects of the lure cap. Alright, as you can see, I'm running around like normal, and it takes a little bit to get into a random battle. You know, it's not too fast, but it's not too slow. Well, alrighty then, we've already demonstrated the effects of using a feather, which, well, that pretty much just made me almost not run into a random battle almost all the time. Alright, well, apparently Ivan learned a new spell and he grew a level. So anyways, let's go on ahead and equip the lure cap really quick, and... wait for it. There we go. See, it took about half the time to run into another battle as what it was doing before. So, pretty much that's all the lure cap is really good for. So, if you really need to use that to level grind or get some gold or just, well, coins, whatever, or anything like that, well, there we go. And also, I'm probably going to end up equipping it at the Venus Lighthouse later just so that way I can, try to grind for a particular weapon for Ivan that I've never been able to get in any of my playthroughs, called the Kikikamunji, I believe. I think it's like the strongest short sword in the game. Don't quote me on that, but I think that's what it is. So let's go on ahead and use lift on this boulder right here. Now, does that continue heading north after we fight a new enemy, a kobold? Not 200% positive what this guy's specialty is or anything like that. All I know is that he's dead. So now that he's gone, we can, well, continue moving on. Yeah, what we want to do now with the cloak ball is actually fight two new enemies, the Warrior Bee and the Rat Warrior. But, the thing that we really want to do with the cloak ball is go through a little side quest, if you remember correctly, to rescue Hammet. Yes, that's the next thing that I will be doing now, viewers, is rescuing Hammet. And then after that, I'm going to continue on with more of the story, and, well, there we go. So that's our next destination as of yet, is to go to Loonpa, actually. So let's go on ahead and jump over here really quick. Grab this treasure chest for a lucky medal. Alright, I can actually use that whenever I come back, though. So, not needing to have to worry about that right now. Also, I should have probably cut this out, but, oh well. Too late now. Doesn't really matter anyways. Let's open up this chest. I'm pretty positive it should be a... it's probably going to end up being a mimic. Or an apple! Alright, I did not at all expect that, so... it boosts attack. We could give that to Mia to boost her attack, but I'm going to go on ahead and give that one... we'll give that one to Garrett. Just because Isaac and Garrett attack a lot more than what Mia and Ivan do. We don't need to go back down there. We need to go over here. Go down here, and, let's see. Alright, well, in that fight, I actually fought two kobolds instead of just one, and I guess that I could have shown it, but, oh well, too little too late for that. So let's move that out of the way. And, well, now that we've actually done that, I'm not really sure exactly where I want to go on this one. Yeah, we want to go over here. I took a glance at a map, but if we go left, then all we'll end up doing is just looping back to the entrance that we were just at. So anyways, now that we are back here, if you can see, Kaylee is right there. That's the cave that connects Tolby, or the Gondawan Passage. It basically connects Tolby to Kaylee, because the boat will not travel in between the two lands anymore because of, like, the Kraken or Colosso being over. I'm not really sure about that. Let's see here. I need to go directly north, so that way I could go on to Vault. So let's go on ahead and start doing that. Okay, well, let's not go to a dead end, first of all. And you know what? I really don't want to have to deal with, like, the weak random battles, so let's try out a Sacred Feather and see if that works. Alright, so hopefully the monsters don't attack as often as the text suggests. Okay, well, maybe they won't attack as often if I quit running into dead ends. Ugh. I'm so fail right now. And I don't even know why. I guess I just am. Maybe it's because I'm not hyper. That's my excuse, and I'm sticking to it, viewers. Let's see, let's just run up north. Yeah, here we go. This is where I was supposed to go. So let's go on ahead and keep on going north. Wow, that Sacred Feather's really working its magic, huh? Oh, well, not anymore. So, I don't feel like wasting another one. I'll just... I'll just start editing out the battles, because, I mean, where we need to go is actually just up there. Let's see, I think it is. Alright. No. That's not it. Alright, fine, I'll go on ahead and use another Sacred Feather, seeing as how I cannot find my way. Alright, there we go. Monster's one attack is often now. Once again, I hope that it keeps its word on that, although I'm not gonna hold it to its word. Yeah, I'll probably end up getting attacked again. Just you wait. Yeah, this is where I'm supposed to go. Yeah, there's Loonpa. Hey, look! A dangling nut! That was not suggestive at all, viewers. That was not. Alright, well, either way, there we go. We get the nut. Cannot quite go in the village. What's with you? Want to enter Loonpa? Yep. Ah, well, that's just very rude. Alright, well, fine, whatever. If you're gonna do all that, then I guess I will just have to sneak in. Be all sneaky sneaky with my new cloak ball. Yeah, if you press that switch right there, the gate will just shut, and we don't want the gate shutting, so we're just gonna end up using Frost. To raise the gate. And as you can see, the switch actually pressed back out, so... That's how you're supposed to get through there. First time I played through, I pressed the switch and pretty much fell for it. Alrighty then, let's see here. I know that there's a bit of treasure raiding that we could do here, so, hold on just a second. Alrighty then, here we go. If we go in here... Yeah, I'm looking at another map, viewers. Don't judge. Wait a second. Look in there. Crud. Let's use reveal. Oh, wait a second. Yeah, reveal's already set to R. So there we go. Oh, wait, no, check that grave. There we go, we could get a smoke bomb right there. Now that we've already done that, come on, run down there. There's nothing in the inn right there, however, if we run up here, we can get... Oh, wait, no, quit doing that. If we run in here, then, alright, there it is. We could get a vial from that particular barrel, or... box. I didn't see which one it was in. If we use reveal right here in the dead center, well, we could get a synergy stone, which I should have really saved, but no, I decided not to. Like a damn idiot. Now, there's nothing in there that we particularly need. If we go in here, then pretty sure there should be something in one of these boxes. Oh, there it is. We could get another lucky medal! Yay! For more gambling! Alright, now that we've already done that, let's run over here and check this barrel. Get another nut, so I guess that we got two nuts over here. Alright, well, that's all that we could grab for right there. However, in order to continue on to the next area, really, what we need to do is use reveal on this, and then after that, promptly use frost. Yeah, the game kind of lags whenever you have two of the things going, but whenever you do that, you have to make sure that the rock is still visible by the time that you run over there and everything. Otherwise, well, yeah, it won't really work out too well in your favor. So let's run on over here, and, oh, come on, I have to use reveal again. There we go, we check that, and after that, the wall crumbles. After that, look at all this treasure! Get a smoke bomb, which is useless. Get a lucky medal, which is not useless. Get 44 coins, which is alright. Get an elixir, which is useless. Get an antidote, which is pretty well useless. And get a water of life, which is not at all useless. Yeah, I'm gonna just make him hold on to a couple of the items, I guess. Okay, well, we've already done all that. So, guess what I get to do now, viewers? I'm going to see if there's any better weapons for Garrett, Ivan, or Mia. I like Isaac's weapon for right now, so I'm going to keep that one equipped. Oh, nope, run in there. There we go. Talk to you. Ah, crud, never mind. I guess that we can't do anything like that. Alright, well, fine. What I want to actually do is, set my new R to cloak. Instead of making it reveal, because whenever we... Yeah, I want to see Dompa. Ah, well, that sucks. Alright, well, let's just try running on in. I'm pretty sure they'll let me through. Don't come any closer to the fortress. What? Oh, okay, well... Yeah, I guess that we can't run into the fortress like that. However, what they never counted on was that I had the ability to cloak myself. Na-na-na-na-boo-boo, stick your head and doo-doo. Yeah, that's how you basically get into the fortress and insult them. So, that's basically what we do, so... Alrighty then, now, this cave is actually surprisingly pretty big. And we have to use the cloak ball quite a bit in here. Let's see here. Hi, let's talk to these people. Now, whenever you talk to these people, nothing really happens. All you really get to do is just talk to them and, you know, they don't throw you out. I don't think that there is an item in there, so I'm not at all worried about that. So, let's just run around over here. Use cloak. Yeah, I might want to run around them. Let's talk to one of them. Ha 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 ha! Playing with them is so much fun. Alright, well anyways, run past them, and obviously they can't see like 20 feet in front of them, so don't have to really worry about that. Let's see here. Need to run on up here. Yeah, don't really need to worry about him right now. Or at least I don't think that you do. Let's run on up here, and well, there we go. Oh, well shoot. Never mind, can't really use cloak there. However, if we check this barrel right here, or this barrel right here, we get another vial, which is awesome. Who goes there? No, don't worry, I'm not a mean thief. Yeah. Oh, okay, well, apparently all the people here in the fortress are very nice, except for the guards. So all we had to do is just use cloak to run right by them. Not all too sure if there are random battles in here or not, but holy crap, Aloni, I'm probably gonna get caught here. No! No! Stop! Why?! Youch! That hurt. And don't come back. My ass, I won't come back. I'm gonna come back all I want. Just because I'm AirPirateCid. You don't tell me what to do. If I want to sneak into your stupid fortress, then I will. Think that you could stop me from sneaking into your fortress? Well, as long as I have the cloak ball, well... You can't stop me. So, pfft, on you. Well, actually, the 15-minute time limit can actually stop me, so, well, lucky for you. That I got my 15-minute time limit. So this time I already know to actually look out for this guy. So now that he's already run by, let's run down here. And there we go. So let's cloak ourselves again. And, let's see, what should I do? Yeah, just run on by him. There, that go up this staircase! Alright. Let's see. Yeah, he's just gonna move left and right. Well, I'm gonna go on ahead and end the video right here. So, thank you all for watching Let's Play Golden Sun! I will see you all in the next episode, or the chapter, or the video, or whatever. So, to where I actually continue on through the, Loompa Forest. And, trust me, we will save Hammet, no matter what. Because I said so.